Park opened in San Diego, California, marking the beginning of a journey that will touch hearts, inspire minds, and protect marine life for generations to come. SeaWorld's 60th anniversary celebration isn't just a marker of time. It's a celebration of progress, innovation, and our unwavering commitment to the wonders of the ocean. And today, as we embark on the next chapter of our journey, we invite you to dive deeper, explore further, and discover that there's so much more to see at SeaWorld Orlando. We are proud of what we do, and it is a privilege for us to care for, build relationships with, teach, and learn from these amazing animals. Now more than ever, we are honored to share our relationships with the whales and what we have learned with all of you. And now, SeaWorld proudly presents Orca Encounter!
Thank you. days, weeks, months, years, building relationships with our whales. This creates trust, and that allows us to do some amazing things. For example, when you visit the doctor, you present your arm to draw blood, or step on the scale to see how much you weigh. It's much the same with our whales.
Today, you'll see the whales moving together in unison. These synchronized behaviors strengthen social bonds and enable them to problem solve as a group. Working together as a team is what makes that emissions talk better. Scientifically known as our science whale, commonly referred to as killer whales, here in SeaWorld we know them as Katina, Lalani, Aaliyah, Turwa, and Makayo, our killer whale family. Makayo is the youngest whale at just 13 years old, and the oldest is Makayo's mother, Katina. This year celebrated her 48th birthday!
Wow! 48th birthday!
It is also the patriarch and leader of our pod. SeaWorld's animal training techniques create a language between us and the whales. It's a language of learning and positive reinforcement, encouragement, commitment, and care. Through these techniques, the whales learn to trust us and even learn to take an active role in their very own health and well-being. Makayo is currently demonstrating one of the very first husbandry or healthcare behaviors that we train, a position in which we ask for a voluntary blessing. The whales learn to roll ventral or upside down and present their tail flips, which gives us a great look at their entire bodies, but also gives us access to blood vessels that can be easily seen along the white underside of those tail flips. Our veterinarians collect the blood sample at least once a month, and the whales are trained to remain calm and relaxed throughout the procedure. As trainers are frequently rubbing down or massaging the whales, whether on their backs, pectoral flippers, or tail flippers. The whales have very sensitive skin, and this is just one way that we can reward them for making calm joint procedures like this, and a great way for us to strengthen our relationships with the whales. Another important diagnostic is weighing the whales, which we can do by asking them to slide onto a killer whale-sized scale located in one of our adjacent booths. When the whales slide up, a portion of their body from their dorsum into their tail flips is still in the water. This is called the peduncle. It's very heavy and very muscular, and it's the powerhouse of the killer whale. In fact, natural athletic behavior that we see in all killer whales is the ability to lift that portion of their body with such force they can turn completely before they enter the water. So in this scenario, to get an accurate weight, we'll simply ask the whales to lift their tails up out of the water. Training this posture enables us to ensure accuracy, so we know that the younger whales are heard properly and the older whales are maintaining a healthy weight.
And the care isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital, and we surprise and engage with our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt, and for the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales and for us.
Hi everyone, I'm over here on the left side of the stadium down by the glass. Did you know that killer whales love to play? They actually learn a lot by playing, through mimicry and observation and learning. From a young age, killer whales learn important life skills by playing games such as follow the leader with their mother and other whales. And we're going to put that to the test today with all of you and our killer whale family! This side of the stadium, go ahead and stand up. You will be the leader and Makayo will follow. So on the count of three, you'll spin in a circle two times, okay? Stand up, everybody! And get ready. One, two, three, spin! Curious animals, and we've seen spy hopping and jumping completely out of the water to get a better look around. Makayo's going to demonstrate this with a bow over the stage, so let's give him a great big cheer! Woo!
Time for all of you, Turwa and Makayo!
they get at the time of year. Unfortunately, overfishing, pollution, and other factors are having a serious impact on some mangrove populations.
Killer whales are aggressive, and it's pretty obvious why they're the top predator in the ocean. That means killer whales are aggressive.
You like it?
Killer whales depend on a plentiful resource and a clean environment. They're completely dominant, yet completely dependent.
When it comes down to it, killer whales are not the most powerful animal in the ocean.
Mystery.